What is up, guys? Happy New Year. It's that time of year again where it's time to update all the content for the new year. And in this video, I want to show you how to create a Google Ads campaign from start to finish in 2024, made in 2024, which means everything you're going to see here as I'm going to show you behind my shoulder will be current and updated and the exact same as you guys will see as well. I've been using Google Ads for the past 7 years now. It's absolutely amazing. It exploded my business, made me over hundreds of thousands of dollars. And I want to show you how you too can utilize this amazing network to make money for yourself. Are you ready? Let's get into it. So the first thing you guys want to do is head over to ads.google.com and create an account by clicking on Start Now. If you have an account, of course, just click on Sign In. Pretty straightforward. Now, once you get into the account, you will most likely see an interface that looks something like this. Okay, now this is important, guys. If you created an account before, or alternatively for some of you, you might see an interface that looks like this. If your interface looks like this, guys, check out my 2023 video. Okay, I'm gonna link it in the description and there should be a little link to the top right of this video somewhere, because this is the interface you will see, some of you, okay? The others, for the newer ones, Google is slowly rolling these changes out. You will see an interface like this, and this is what I'm going to show you in this updated 2024 video. So once you're here, you want to select on campaigns because we want to create a new campaign. We're going to click on the plus sign and we're going to click on new campaign. Now, what I'm gonna do here for the purpose of this video is promote my website, yvonmanna.com. You guys, of course, will promote your own content. So we're gonna go with website traffic here, and we're gonna go with search campaign. So for the purpose of this video, we're gonna focus on search because I believe, and it is really the lowest hanging fruit to making money with Google Ads, because you're just giving people what they're looking for. So whatever people are typing into Google, your ads are gonna show, okay? So pretty straightforward. So we're gonna enter my website here, https://www.yvonmanna.com. Now, you might not have any conversions set up yet, conversion tracking, don't worry about that. You do need to select something though, so just select the page view for now. I will make another video showing you how to set up conversion tracking because that is absolutely important for you guys so you know what works and what doesn't. So we're gonna enter a campaign name. Let's say Yvon Manna Free Guide because that is what I'm offering on my website. Feel free to check it out yourself, yvonmanna.com. We're going to keep this off. This is just enhanced conversions for your account. Now, we don't have any conversion data, so this isn't really relevant for us right now. But once you do set it up, once you have conversion tracking, that could be useful. So we will exit the guide because I am your guide for this video. And so we can't really focus on conversions yet. We don't have conversion tracking set up. The simplest thing to do here would just be to focus on clicks. So we're gonna focus on clicks. We're gonna set a maximum cost per click limit. Let's go with 15 cents, right? Now this totally depends on your niche. If you're a lawyer and you're targeting certain law keywords, you might be paying upwards of $300, $400 per click, right? So that's insane. But I'm just gonna put 15 cents here for an example because it doesn't hurt to put something low and then you can increase it if you don't see the clicks you want, right? As opposed to putting in $400 and then spending everything in 2 minutes, right? So we're gonna say next. Now over here, this is the search network. So do you wanna show your ads also on Google search partner networks? Used to be like Ask Jeeves, you know, things like that. Or do you wanna strictly show it on Google? So let's suppose we wanna strictly show it on Google. We're gonna deselect it. And of course, this option here, this is a whole different beast. I suggest you always have this off if you're running search ads, because for display campaigns, I recommend creating a whole different campaign for it. It's a whole other beast with a whole separate targeting metric there. So here we're gonna set the location. We're gonna enter, let's say United States and Canada. We're gonna click enter. We're gonna type Canada. We're gonna click enter. Let's say these two for now. Obviously, you can enter whatever other countries you want. Now, it is important to go into location settings and to target presence here. Okay, this is an important thing, guys. Pay attention. You have to select this presence thing here because if you select presence or interest, then let's suppose you're selecting US here. If somebody in China types in, you know, your keyword plus US, your ad will show up to them, but you might have no interest to showing somebody in other countries, right? So you want to make sure presence so that you're targeting actually just these people, okay, in these countries. Now the language, this doesn't translate. This just targets people who speak this language, okay? So if I select French here, my ads, which I will type in English, will be shown to French speakers. Probably not something I want, but If you do speak a different language, this is where you would type in and select the language that your ad is in. So you will show your ad to those people who speak that language. Okay, Google makes it very easy for you. Audience segments, we're going to leave this blank for now because we don't have any remarketing lists yet. We haven't set up any lists, which again, I will create a video on how to do that. I do have a 2023 video, however, if you want to see with the previous layout how to set that up. We're going to click on more settings here. You don't have to change much here. This is pretty standard, pretty good. So we'll leave it as is. Now over here, this is the meat and bones of your campaign, the keywords. Okay, this is probably the most important part of your campaign creation process, because over here, you're selecting which people you want to show your ads to. What do people have to type in to show your ads? So you could enter a keyword here and get suggestions. As you can see, Google already here gave me some pretty good suggestions, you know, affiliate marketing for dummies, affiliate marketing jobs. So Google scanned my website and noticed that this is what my website is about, and it gave suggestions. Sometimes Google might not scan your site so accurately. So what you can do is you can type in, for example, affiliate marketing guide, and you can click on update suggestions. And yes, we're okay to replace all of those. And they're going to give us other suggestions like create a website for affiliate marketing, you know, how to set up affiliate program, things like that. And so when somebody types something like this in, affiliate marketing guide, your ads will show up. Now, there are these three match types. Okay, I'm going to quickly go over them. But if you want more detail, I do suggest you check out my comprehensive 5-hour course that covers everything in very thorough detail. You can find it at ivanmana.com/all-courses. But let me just quickly explain to you roughly how this works, right? So you have these three different match types. Let me start with exact here. So if I put in square brackets, this keyword, for example, then somebody has to type in pretty much this exactly, okay? Affiliate marketing guide, or something to do with affiliate marketing guide. So maybe guide on affiliate marketing, or affiliate marketing guide, or affiliate marketing guide for me. If somebody types any of these in as an example, your ad will show to them, okay? Now, if somebody types in something like affiliate marketing for dummies, it might not show up because it's not as specific. Google decides it, okay? So if Google decides that if somebody types in affiliate marketing for dummies is similar to guide, then your ad will show up, okay? So it's up to Google. You can't really predict this stuff, but that's what this exact match is. Then you have phrase match. Phrase match is a bit more loose, okay? So that means people can type in affiliate marketing for beginners, beginners affiliate marketers, how to get started with affiliate marketing for beginners. If somebody types anything like that in, your ads will show up. So it's a bit more loose, okay? It covers more potential search terms for your ad to show up. And lastly, you have broad, which is very broad. It's actually very broad. I don't suggest you guys use broad at all. So for broad, you don't have to put any parentheses or square brackets or anything like that. If you just type in how to do affiliate marketing in broad, then if somebody types in that Google deems relevant in any way to affiliate marketing, your ads will show up. So if somebody types in Amazon Associates, your ad might show up, even though Amazon Associates has nothing to do with my guide, right? But Amazon Associates is an affiliate platform. So Google might think, okay, affiliate equals Amazon Associates. Let's do this. Okay. So it's very broad. I do not suggest you do it unless you have an insanely high budget and you're okay with just spending money to find these rare gems. But I would suggest you stick to phrase or exact. Okay. So that's what these are. Now we can go in and we can kind of add these square brackets to each keyword here, or what's going to be faster is we're going to publish this campaign and then I'm going to show you how to go back in and then how to do it faster. So you can apply, for example, phrase or exact to all these keywords right away, okay? So let's suppose this is it, right? So we want to target people searching for affiliate marketing guide or blog or something like that. Of course, you can go through the keywords, you can delete whichever ones don't make sense to you. Let's say, yeah, how to make an affiliate website. Let's suppose it's not relevant. We can go in and delete it. Boom. Okay. Simple as that. You could also add more if you like. Affiliate marketing guide or Ivan Mana. You can do that. Okay. Now, this is the actual ad. So this is what is shown to people. So when you can add a display path. The display path is what shows up over here. So if I type in excellent, it's going to show up here. Give it a second to load. Right there. Ivan Mana, excellent. Now, this isn't really relevant. So let's say free guide, actually. That makes more sense. And then these are your headlines, okay? This is what shows up. So my rule of thumb is, and I have a whole video dedicated to what makes a good headline, is to actually have the keyword for what you're offering. So if I'm offering a free guide, I'm gonna say free affiliate marketing guide. That's as straightforward as can be. It tells people exactly what they're looking for. Here, learn
to make money online, for example. Make money online, sure. We can delete Yvonne Mana. Now, we want this to be as a headline one, right? Or at least I do in my case. I want this to show up in the first position because I think this is the most important and this represents what my guide is about. Now, we also want a second headline. As a rule of thumb, my second headline is a call to action. So I'm going to say something like get started now, learn more now. And then we're going to put these to position two. Maybe we can say get your guide now, okay? So prompting people to take action. Now, for the third headline, it doesn't always show, but I like to describe it. So for example, 55-page affiliate guide. And then we can pin this to position three. So this is what our ad would look like. You can see here in the preview, you can see all these different variations. Free affiliate marketing guide, get started now, right? Learn to make money online. So this would be an ad for my guide, for my website, for my ad. Then you have the descriptions. So by the way, over here, you have a maximum of 30 characters. For the description, you have a maximum of 90. So yeah, this looks pretty good. I like this one, my 7 years of affiliate marketing experience. Work with an affiliate marketing expert, get started today. These are actually pretty good. I actually like these descriptions. This is pretty good too. We know how to make money while you sleep. And then maybe we can also test it by saying, learn how to make money while you sleep. These are actually really good. I'm actually surprised. Google did a pretty good job in this case. Good job, Google. And then in this case, we don't have to set, like you can also set it position one or two, but I'm not gonna change it here. I think these are okay to be randomized. Any of these are fair game. So then you have business name and logos. Now you can't really do this yet. You have to be verified, okay? So you have to verify your account by A, entering your billing information, and B, you also have to verify your profile. So verify that your business name is your actual business name, verify the address of the business, things like that. Once you do that, you'll be able to add your business name and logo. So that over here, instead of this little world sign, it'll be your logo. And instead of YvonneMana.com or just above it, it'll say your business name, okay? So if you wanna do that, looks kinda cool, you can do it. If you prefer to stay anonymous, you don't have to do that. Now you also have extensions, site link and callout. We're gonna skip these for now. These are extensions that you don't need. They're beneficial, but you don't need it to create an ad, okay? I just wanna show you the basics here in this video. And then here you have more extensions. So this is basically it. Now you might see that your ad strength is poor. It's okay. You know, you could always come back and change it. You don't have to come in here and just focus on this too much. You can always come back and always edit it. And I'm going to show you how to do that. But if you do want to improve it, you can look at ideas here and you can make the headlines unique. So these headlines, they're, you know, they have a lot of make money online. They're not too unique. So you can go ahead and change it. For example, earn money online. Now let's see if that changes anything. Not really, but that's the idea, right? So just do what it says here. Like, let's look at ideas. Yeah, affiliate marketing tools, sign up now. Yeah. So just, those are fine. So that is pretty much it. Let's see what the next steps are. Let me close out of that. That's our ad. We're going to click on next. And then here we want to set the budget. Set whatever is comfortable for you. If you're not sure what to set, I also have a video showing you how to properly set your budget. So take a look at that video. You can set a custom budget right here. Let's suppose we want to do $20, okay? You can see an estimate here of clicks for our keywords that we set. This is an estimate, okay? So we're estimated to get 700 weekly clicks roughly. Don't take it too hard. It's not 100%. It's just something that could be. But you can always change your bid and budget. I'm going to show you how to do that. Google is now going to check for errors, and our campaign is almost ready to publish. So you can take a look, make sure everything is good, okay? And then we can click on publish campaign. I do strongly suggest you guys also set up conversion tracking because that is what's going to allow you to actually see what works, what doesn't, okay? So now that you've done that, if you click on campaigns, if you click on campaigns over here, we're gonna see our campaign here. If you click on Yvonne Mana free guide, similar segments, yeah, I'm not sure what that is. We can just dismiss that. You have the ad group here. So this ad group, we can name it affiliate marketing guide and click save. And then you can obviously duplicate this. So if you click here, you can click on copy and then paste, and then you'll be able to create another ad group, and then you can come in and add new keywords, right? So if you click on this ad group here, you'll see all the keywords. And then I promised I'll tell you how to change the keywords right away, right? So you can do it one by one by just selecting the match type here, or you can select them all. And then if you have more than like 50 keywords or so, it'll tell you select more than those 50. So just click on that. If you want to change everything, don't forget. And then we can click on edit, change match types, and change all match types. Change them to, let's say, exact. We're going to click on apply. And then now all of these should become exact, just like that, without us needing to actually go in there and set those square brackets for everything, right? So there you go. These are all exact. You have your ads here. You have your assets. These are the extensions, which I'm not going to cover in this video. It's like an additional asset, you know, make your ads stand out a little bit more. But I do have videos on that, and I cover that in detail in my training course. And then you have your ad groups, campaigns. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. Now, if you go to campaigns over here, if you click on this option here, they no longer have a settings option. So in the old interface, they used to have a little settings button you can click on. Now it's over here. So if you click on campaigns, over here is where you can adjust things at the campaign level, right? So your location, your language, your budget, the bidding. If you want to increase, by the way, the bid, you can do that here, okay? You can make it higher, make it lower. So if you're not getting enough impressions, that's what you would do. Now, just so you guys know, let me also explain a little bit what these columns mean. So impressions are how many people see your ad, okay? Just see your ad. Clicks, where's clicks? Clicks here are how many people click on your ad, okay? The CTR is the clicks divided by impressions. So if you get 10 clicks out of 100 times people saw your ad, that's 10% CTR, okay? The higher the CTR, the better. As a rule of thumb, you're looking for about 4 to 6% CTR is good, but it really depends on your keywords, whether they're broad, whether they're exact, what niche you're in, whether they're long tail keywords, which means three words or more. It depends on all that, so I can't just tell you. You know, it's not a black and white answer. Now, the other thing you can do here is you can modify columns. And for example, you can put the cost over here, and then you can come in and move the clicks, you know, a little bit up higher, maybe close to impressions. And then once you set up conversion tracking, you can come in here and you can say, okay, I want to track conversions and I want to track my cost per conversion. You can do that here. Then you can save it. Let's say default column set, we can click save and apply. And then you're gonna see everything here. And that is pretty much it, guys. Congratulations, you've successfully created your campaign and your ads should start running as soon as they're approved. And assuming that you've set up your billing and that everything is fine, there are no issues, all right? If you guys enjoyed this video and you want to learn more, I do invite you to check out my YouTube playlist on Google Ad videos, where I have a plethora of different types of content around Google Ads. But I also have a website at ivanmana.com you can go to, and I have very detailed step-by-step training courses over here, Google Ads Mastery and Google Ads Retargeting, that guides you through in very thorough detail how to not only set up your Google Ads account and optimize it for maximum performance, but also how to retarget and how to create these audiences so you can run ads to those people again so they see your ads again, all right? That said, hope this was helpful. Let me guys know in the comments what you thought. Is there something else you want me to cover? Is there something that I missed? And thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.